morning, everyone. This is Dr. Hema Ambika from the Department of Research from St. Martin's Engineering College. Today, I would like to discuss about the topic of NMR. NMR, it is named as Nuclear Magnetic Resonance Spectroscopy. So, this is one kind of spectroscopic part, as we already discussed in the before video that IR spectroscopy principle. Now, I am going to discuss about the principle of NMR spectroscopy. So it is named as Nuclear Magnetic Resonance Spectroscopy. So as the spectroscopy belongs to electromagnetic radiation. So here so many kinds of radiations like cosmic radiations, gamma radiations, UV radiations, visible radiations, IR, microwaves and radio waves. So here we need to discuss the nuclear magnetic resonance. Nuclear study. Nuclear, it is nothing but the center part of an atom, which is consisting of protons as well as neutrons into that. So when a radiation is falling on the substance, then the protons will get into excited, or which will read or study of a nuclear part. Okay, it is named as nuclear magnetic. In the presence of magnetic field, the resonance study can be occur in the presence of a electromagnetic radiation. So out of this series, there is a radiation called radio frequency radiation. This radio frequency radiations are used to find the nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy. Here, the nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy study, we will discuss the principle of NMR today. Radio frequency radiations are the source of radiations to read nuclear part, especially protons. So, how to read the proton resonance? By using this. As we know that a top is revolving or continuously takes a revolution when we apply a force on this. At the same time, here the proton also shows that kind of resonances. Proton characteristics. Why we are using this one as a characteristic part? Depending upon its characteristics, proton is a charged particle. That is its first characteristic. It is a charged particle, consisting of a positive charge, at the same time which is having spin nature, which shows either positive half spin or negative half spin, okay, and which is continuously takes the resolutions or revolutions continuously without any stopping in that, okay, and at the same time like a top, when you observe a top, there is a line. Based upon this line, the top will be taking the resolutions. So it is a magnetic vector of the proton. So magnetic vector will be present in the proton spinning. Magnetic vector. Okay, and which takes continuous revolutions either any kind of clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. This it is called resolutions. Or it is named as precessions. Precessions are nothing but revolutions or resolutions. For example, a top will be like this. If you are applying a force to which, then automatically which takes the resolutions continuously. Or it is named as precessions in terms of a proton. Okay. So how much frequency of a radio waves are required to resonate this or to take the precisions to reach? Okay, that is its resonance. Okay, so for which takes certain kind of angles with the spin momentum, so it is known as spin angular momentum, which is represented with I. Okay, at the same time, magnetic vector is there. Magnetic, a charged particle which is having a spinning nature and also consisting of possessing like a bar magnetic or magnetic in nature, which possessing some kind of magnetic field surrounding to it, it is named as bar magnet. So the fourth point, the fourth characteristic, it is nothing but which acts as a bar magnet. Bar magnet, it is nothing but magnetic vector, it is. So it is nothing but any particle which is possessing some spinning nature, some charged material which is having some kind of magnetic in nature itself and possessing some kind of magnetic field. For suppose it is a proton and which is possessing some kind of magnetic nature surrounding to this, it is named as bar magnet. Okay guys, next one, which also possessing magnetic field, so which is consisting of magnetic momentum. So it is represented with a nucleus. Okay, so these are the different characteristics exhibited by the nucleus, that is nothing but proton. When a radio frequency radiation falling on this proton, then how this can be flipped or which can take the different kinds of transitions into in its energy levels. Okay, so that we will discuss. So these are the different characteristics. Now let us have a look on principle. What is the principle? What is the principle? Here it is a principle, it is called the nucleus or the proton is exhibited or it is irradiated with radio frequency radiations, then which takes flipping or which can excite it to its excited levels, from ground level to excited levels, which can travel. Okay, so this is a proton in its ground energy level, this is called ground state, this is called ground state, and which is excited to the its excited level and where there is taking and flipping. So it is resolution in this direction and which is flipping in its excited level. So it is the direction like this. This is named as excited loop. Excited, and where this is the energy difference between them. For suppose it is E1, this is E2, the proton will be in the ground energy level in this direction. This direction is named as aligned direction or aligned direction. Okay, this is opposite direction. This is opposite direction, this is aligned direction, or it is named as alpha state and it is named as beta state. It is named as alpha state and it is named as beta state. It is otherwise known as ground, excited, or aligned, or this one, opposite state. Okay, so when it is showing precisions in this direction, when an IR radiation, radio frequency radiation falling on a substance, then automatically which is flipped and which can take the precisions. So this condition, it is named as flipped condition, flipped state, or it is flipped. For which how much energy is required from the radio frequency radiation, this statin is named as NMR. Okay, for this, the condition, what is the condition? The condition, it is nothing but I not equal to 0. I, it is nothing but spin angular momentum. Spin angular momentum. So how this can be calculated, let us discuss. So for this, the condition will be like this, and one, there are two conditions to observe nuclear magnetic resonance. First condition it is which requires radio frequency radiation. Another condition is external magnetic field is required. External magnetic field is required. So this is the principle. Now let us have a look on how it is applicable. First of all, any proton can be randomized in its direction. Any proton can be randomly oriented. This is randomly oriented, random direction. When H0 or V0, you can call it as external magnetic field, when it is applicable, then automatically there is a direction alignment or there is some specific direction will be occur to this randomized direction. Okay, so the direction will be either in this direction. If you are applying radio frequency radiations, immediately which captures the radio frequency radiation when it is irradiated on this, then automatically there is a splitting of energy states like ground state as well as excited state. If suppose the ground state consisting of an aligned state and the excited state is consisting of a flipped state. Okay, so this is otherwise is spinning nature of plus half as well as minus half. For this, the energy is required to flip a proton from its ground energy level to excited energy level, that it is named as minus mu beta h naught by I. Minus mu beta h naught by I. Where mu it is nothing but its magnetic momentum, beta is a gyroscopic ratio, h naught is external magnetic field, or you can put it as v naught, and I is the spin angular momentum. So here, depending upon mu value as well as I value, there are splitting energy states like plus half here we can take in the ground energy level and minus half we can take in the excited energy level. So this is the basic principle of NMR spectroscopy. Okay, then now we can able to understand where should we use this or what are the purpose to read the NMR spectroscopy. So NMR spectroscopy is to read the isotopes. You suppose carbon is there, 6C12, it is carbon element. Its isotopes are 6C13, 6C14. Like there is so many isotopes of every element in the periodic table can be observed, but out of which those are NMR active molecules and those are not NMR active molecules depending on the I values. Let us discuss which are IR inactive, which are IR non mean active molecules. So here NMR active molecules. What are NMR active molecules? Let us discuss about I value. I is the spin angular momentum. Spin angular momentum. This is always not equal to zero. Then only the elements are named as NMR active. When it is I equal to zero, those elements are named as NMR inactive molecules. Okay. How can this be calculated? This is calculated depending upon the number of proton values as well as number of neutron values. Okay, so that is named as I value. So the summation of number of protons as well as number of neutrons in an atom can displace the value of I. So whether I equal to 0 or I equal to not equal to 0 depending upon these two summation. Right. Let us take an example. Let us take a understanding that number of protons, number of neutrons, how the I value. Okay, what are the examples? Let us have a look. For example, protons will be even. Proton, as you know, proton it is nothing but atomic number. And number of neutrons. For example, number of neutrons is also even. Okay, then automatically these two summation gives that even value. Okay, so then I becomes 0. I becomes 0 means how can we estimate means all the spins will be get cancelled out. Opposite spins, then we will get I equal to 0. That is our understanding. But here, when it is even, the summation will get even as you know, and I equal to 0 here in this condition. For example, 6C12. Let us take that here 6 atomic number, whereas this is a mass number. Mass number it is nothing but protons plus neutrons. Proton it is nothing but the atomic number, so it is 6. So number of neutrons will also be 6. So protons plus neutrons equal to 6 plus 6, even plus even, which gives it 12, is also even. For this kind of molecules, the I becomes 0. These are NMR inactive molecules. NMR inactive molecules. For example, here it is even, it is odd value. Then the summation, it is odd value. Then I values gives as fraction values like 3 by 2, 5 by 2, etc., which will give. From this understanding, we can give an example of 6C13. For example, it is even, this is odd. So it is a mass member, atomic number plus mass member. So it is even, this is odd. So when we are taking this kind of elements, for example, 8O7. So this is also 8 plus 9. Okay, so these are the examples which can give IR active. So these are the elements. So even number of protons, odd number of neutrons, which give active number of NMR strength. Next, here it is odd, here it is even, the summation gives us odd. These also giving half, 3 by 2, 5 by 2, etc. values. So for this example can be 7 and 15. last point is odd and odd values. These two summation gives us even. Okay, for this I becomes 1. So I is a 1, though it is an IR enamer active, but there is a non-equal distribution or non-saturation position will be there. So this is not applicable purely. For this, we can able to tell an example of 7 and 14. So here 7 plus 7, proton number plus neutron numbers. So these are the examples for I equal to 1 value. We are telling that those molecules which are those isotopes which are exhibiting these type of proton value and neutron value, those are named as NMR active molecules.